Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to create a reverse reverb effect on a drum track. I'll be using a virtual drum plugin to create the drum sound, and this will be applied to the snare drum. For this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create this effect in Reaper. Before we get started, here's an example of the kind of effect that we'll be creating. With this drum sound, I've separated out the snare drum so we can apply the reverse reverb to only that part of the kit. Now let's get started. The first thing we need to do is reverse our original snare track. Right-click on the snare track, go to Item Settings, and select Reverse Active Take. Now our snare track is completely reversed. At this point, we can add a reverb effect to that track. Press the Effects button and add a reverb. I'm using a reverb called Ambience by Smart Electronics. This is a free reverb VST plugin, and for more of those that you can use with Reaper, check out my other video on that topic. I'll link to that video in the video description down below. Obviously, if you're doing this with an acoustic kit, you'll need to mute all the other tracks and possibly use a noise gate to isolate the snare on that track, but for this example, we have all the other parts of the kit combined in one track. I'll add damping to the reverb starting at around 950 Hz. That gets rid of the high frequencies and creates a darker reverb, which I find works better with this effect. I'll set the decay time to 1600 milliseconds and set the size to a little under 50%. We need to make sure the reverb completely decays between each snare hit, otherwise we'll have a constant noise in our track and it won't sound right after it's reversed. Regardless of what plugin you use, make sure you don't make the reverb too long and set it to 100% wet so only the reverb goes through the effect. After we're done with the reverb sound, we can apply it to the track. Right-click on the snare track and select Apply Track/Take Effects to Item as New Take. This gives us one take on that track for the original reverse snare sound and another for the reverb. We want these takes as separate tracks, so right-click, go under Takes, and select Explode All Takes to New Tracks. At this point, we can delete the original snare track or just mute it. Since these are new tracks, we should rename them. The first one is Dry Snare, and the second is Wet Snare. So now we have our separate tracks, but they're still reversed. Right-click on the Dry Snare, go to Item Settings, and uncheck Reverse Active Take. Then right-click on the Wet Snare, go to Item Settings, and Reverse Active Take. Since the Wet Snare is a new file that we created, Reaper doesn't consider it to be reversed to begin with, so that's why the original file is unchecked while the other is checked. Now we have all the tracks playing in the right direction, and we've created our reverse reverb sounds. Since these are on separate tracks, we can easily adjust the levels and apply equalization. The original snare track is untouched, but any effects that were on the effects chain would need to be transferred over to the new one after we exploded the takes to new tracks. Thanks for checking out this tutorial on how to create a reverse reverb sound in Reaper. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. Also, check out our social media links in the video description to stay up to date on all our new content.